Hello folks, if you have ever been curious about which path you should choose in order to become an expert iOS application developer, then you are in the right place. I am Mohsin Sharif and I am going to teach you the roadmap for beginners. Before starting the video, I'll tell a bit about myself. I started my professional career from the same university from where I graduated as an iOS application developer as well as conducting iOS tutorial classes. Before coming to the Korea, I was working as a senior iOS application developer in IT consulting company and a telecommunication company. In my 2-year professional careers, I successfully published 4 applications to the App Store and the 5th one was a live streaming app was in the testing phase. After coming to Korea, I worked as a TA and started teaching C programming language to the students. It's been 3 years in Korea and I have done my master's and now enrolled in PhD. That was a brief introduction of myself. Now let's get back to the subject. There are 2 prerequisites in terms of hardware and software. In hardware, you must have Mac machine such as iMac or MacBook. In software, you must have Xcode installed on it and you are ready to go with your development. There are 6 basic steps which you should follow in order to become an iOS application developer. First, learn Swift programming language. Swift is an intuitive programming language developed by Apple and open source community. There is another programming language, Objective-C, but there are some reasons why you should choose Swift over Objective-C. To see why, please go and watch my another video, Swift vs. Objective-C. Second, learn iOS application development lifecycle. The current state of your app determines what it can and cannot do at any time. To learn more, go and read Managing Your App Lifecycle documentation by Apple. Third, learn the iOS application controls and their behavior. Open an application on your iPhone, which you use most, and start observing the behavior. For example, Facebook. You are commenting on your friend's post, watching videos, and moving from one view to another, and coming back. How all these are happening, and data is being shared? For all these tasks, delegates, protocols, and notifications are responsible. Go hacking with Swift website and search for it. You will get in-depth explanation and sample code as well. Number 4, learn how to integrate third-party libraries. Third-party libraries can be easily integrated in your application by using tools such as Carthage and CocoaPods. And according to the CocoaPods official website, there are 83,000 libraries and is being used over 3 million apps. Go to Google or YouTube and search how to install and use CocoaPods in your application. As now you are in the iOS application development, let's take a bit deeper dive. From now onward, I'm separating the application into 2 parts, front-end and back-end. Front-end is the screen design which we see and interact with them, and the back-end where our tasks and operations are being performed in nature. Number 5. Learn the screen designing. Start with the Swift UI and also read the Human Interface Guideline by Apple to get in-depth information and UI resources for designing the great front-end of your app. Number 6. Learn the back-end. Our back-end is actually responsible for our action and especially for the data. The data which is stored somewhere on your phone local memory or on the data server like AWS Amplify or Firebase. And our backend is getting this data by using API and passing it to the frontend so that we can see. Most of the time, data servers return the data in the form of JSON. And in the backend, it is most important to understand how to handle the JSON object and parse it to the application, model, or entity. At this stage, you are familiar with the most required skills in order to become an iOS application developer. And now you can start building your own first iOS application. These are the basic steps to become an iOS application developer. If you have any suggestion or feedback, please leave it on the comment section below. Stay tuned with us. I'll be back with other helping videos.